This week, I didn't do much social stuff, so I had a lot of time writing. I increased my stockpile a little tiny bit, but I'm happy about it. I wrote this week a big 2,500 words info dump chapter, and then I thought, let's use it to introduce more of Eddie. Eddie is a friend of Laura. There was already a phone call with him in chapter 16 or 15. He was the guy who suggested to Flora to do jiu-jitsu. Flora suggested to him to join her in virtual reality, and now he got his pot, and they go on their first, not adventure, but on their first outing to get together. For me, friendship is very important. I hold my friends very dear, and I love to read about friendship as well, because yeah, it's an important part of my life, and I like to read about it as well. I mentioned before that I thought it was great that Harry Potter and Hermione didn't become a couple, that they were friends and are still friends. I want to write a friendship as well, and this is Flora's friendship with Edgar. They have different genders, and I didn't realize how difficult it would be to let this friendship remain friendshipy, but I'm fighting for it. In my blurb, I wrote that my novel will not contain romance, and I'm still subscribing to this promise. But it's hard as is too much, but it's tempting, let's say this way, to write a bit of romance, a bit of flirting. But I think a tiny bit of flirting is okay in friendships, right? Write in the comments what you think of this. Yeah, but friendship, great. And so I thought about a friendship in literature in general, and I watched a video. I forgot the big booktuber's name, but she's a pretty big booktuber. I look it up and write it somewhere. She did something where she did a kind of poll, and this poll showed that many people have the same opinion than me, that they want to read more friendships. And so I'm glad about this, and if you like friendships, read my novel Antitos, the VR MMORPG. Yeah, and I thought about a book which was one of the worst depictions of this whole friendship versus romance topic I've read. And this is That Witch Walking from Kim Harris. In this book, the MC has no friends at all, only people who want to get in her pants, and people she abuses, and people who she wants to get in the pants of. Something's wrong with the sentence, but you know what I mean. There's only dancing and romancing and abusing, and no kind of friendship anywhere. So I forgot the title of the book and the author, and I don't know what it's about. So I thought, I look it up, and went to my Goodreads, and then read a review, and the review was like, yes, the things I said about friendships, there were things about bitchiness, and while reading it, I thought, yes, yes, that's exactly my opinion on this book. What a great review. And I looked for somewhere I can like this review, didn't find a button there. And then I realized that I had written this review myself. So, yeah, it read really 100% my opinion. I thought I'd tell you about it because I thought it was funny. But, I mean, it's all okay that I didn't change my opinion in the meantime. But I haven't read the book in the meantime. So I read it a few years ago. I can't really tell. I mean, the high time of urban fantasy was a few years ago, I believe. The non-romantic urban fantasy. Good, that's to my storybook progress. I'm now in the second info dump chapter, and Eddie is still there to add a bit of color to it. But I hope this chapter won't get as long as the other chapter. Yeah. On the non-writing side of life, I re-equipped my Fitbit and I want to get it to 10,000 steps a day. I don't say I will take 10,000 steps because I am Beat Sabering it. You could think this is cheating, but I don't think so. Beat Saber is honest to God very athletic. It's a very athletic endeavor. The second game I play is a Space Pirate. This is, yeah, it's quite engaging as well. You don't get steps for Space Pirate, so I get even more sports than the 10,000 steps. Of course, I do a walk as well, so they are not all Beat Saber generated steps. Today it's about 6,000 steps or 7,000 steps by walking. Yeah, 3,000 to 4,000 by Beat Sabering. So what about next week? I haven't planned anything special. Maybe a short visit to the bank. I think maybe I can get my stockpile to 6 chapters. I think I get it this week. I think I will get it next week. Yeah? I know I tried it a few times, but this time I don't feel half bad about it. I feel half good about it. Not 100% good, but we see it all. Another thing happened last week. My subscriber count stagnated. It might even be the second week it stagnated. It was, I have to look at a summary again. I think I was at 580 subscribers on Royal Road 2 weeks ago, then 1 week ago at 601. And now I'm at 602 or 603 subscribers. So I was pretty bummed out about it. It affected me negatively, let's say this way. The thing is, the chapters got very much positive feedback. But subscribers left. I think 5 to 10 subscribers left. Every time I posted a new chapter, okay, there came still some new ones, but yeah, it's... So I can't explain it why they left. And this is a bit, this is puzzling to me, and it's... I don't know how I can find out why they left. I asked some of my current readers, and they... our writers as well, and I said, yeah, it's pretty typical that people are leaving as soon as you upload a new chapter because they get reminded and then they think, oh, this story, no, not at the moment and probably not in the near future. And so they unsubscribe not to be bothered by these update messages.
Yeah.
And they could leave a comment. I mean, yeah, I mean, the only thing which is worse than bad comments is no comments at all, in my opinion, yes. So if you see this and you have the plan to unsubscribe, please leave a message, right? Yeah, I can't promise not to do the reason you are leaving anymore, yes, but at least I know and I have the chance to correct it. But I have a few new statistical tools with the Scribble Hub. Scribble Hub has a feature that lets people give hearts to chapters. Other platforms have the feature to let me see what chapters weren't completely read, namely Wattpad. I combined these two features, got some data from it. I formerly thought that the people who are left because of a bad chapter, but they left because of the chapter before the bad chapter. And that was the really interesting thing. So chapter something is off with chapter 12. Chapter 13, many people left. And I thought, oh, something's off with chapter 13 or chapter 9, the bank robbery. But the fault was in chapter 8 and in chapter 12. So this is good. I don't know what the fault of these two chapters are, but yeah, at least I know something with these two chapters isn't right. And I spoke with two friends of mine, and both stopped reading my story at chapter 11 and chapter 12. So they didn't stop because they didn't like it, but yeah, sometimes you stop. And but it is interesting to know when you stop reading something. So chapter 8 and chapter 12 is definitely on my list to further look into it. Yeah, the chapters in the last week were. Many people left were not on crafting, but on free running and martial arts. So one reviewer even said that he didn't enjoy the skating parts. There are no skating parts in my story, but free running parts. So I think he meant that, and it shows me that he enjoyed it, that he didn't enjoy it to such an extent that he couldn't even differentiate free running and skating. So yeah. So yeah, it's pretty interesting, but I don't know the way forward. I don't know, yeah, I should just reread the two chapters a few times, 8 and 13. Maybe the chapters of the last week as well after that, if I can find something common about them. Yeah. And chapter 2 is seemingly a not that great chapter as well. It only got 2 hearts on Scribble Hub, and this is the lowest amount of hearts out of any of my chapters. There are some other chapters who only get 2 hearts, like chapter 8. Yeah. Chapter 12, I'm not so sure. I think it got 4 hearts, but a chapter around it got more hearts. So it was perceived as weaker as the other chapters surrounding it. Yeah, I mean, that's really great about that fiction, that you can, that you get immediate feedback, and that you can glean additional details from statistics if you are mad and like statistics. Yeah. So this is on my list as well, to get a feeling of what made my readers stop reading the stories or disliking those chapters. Good. Great. That's it for this week. Yeah, see you on Sunday, maybe sooner, but Sunday. See you, ciao!